This is Leslie Bennett, the partner of Stephanie in Star Apple Landscaping, and I am so impressed with all you've done, and especially with these fruit trees.
Thank you.
Tell me, how do you incorporate those into your designs?
Well, basically, we incorporate fruit trees in almost every design that we do. We really think it's one of the best ways for people to get started with growing food. A lot of people associate growing food with so much hard work and all these seasonal changes, but really with fruit trees, it's so low maintenance. It's really such a simple way to change the way you interact with your landscape. We see so many of the sad, fruitless plum trees, and introducing an apple tree, or we love persimmons as well, is a really great way to get going and to start making your landscape productive. So we have 23 heirloom apple trees here in this exhibit.
Wow.
And we just thought it was a really fun way to show people the diversity and like the way you can actually just have fun with your landscape and have different experiences.
I think it's great that you would replace ornamental flowering fruit trees with the real thing.
And I think so too.
I did that on my property this year.
Did.
Yeah, I put all peaches where I had flowering.
There you go.
So yay, I did the right thing.
Yeah, you did. We totally agree.
So do you have a favorite? Is your do your customers have a favorite? Is there something that is just, you know, hands down the best?
Yeah, I mean, I think apple trees in general are a major hit. Kids love them. Most people can remember one from their youth that they grew up really loving. I think Sierra Beauty and Gravenstein's are really delicious. I also love the Anna apple.
Yeah.
So some pretty straightforward ones. But we also have Arkansas Black here. We've got 23 others as well, and it's exciting.
Beautiful, even without having fruit or even any leaves on them yet.
Yeah.
The caliper is huge.
Mm-hmm. And I love that they're all just flowering, and you really get that sense of spring. You feel spring with the apple trees, and that's really nice.
Love it. Thank you for all you're doing.
Too.
Some of your customers have tight spaces, and
yes,
maybe they're worried about a big apple tree. What is your solution?
Well, we just love to tell people about multi-graft apple trees and espalier apple trees. Everybody's like, espalier, what? And
that.
This is
it's
it. It's an old European technique that actually yields higher production per square foot of apple tree, which is awesome. And they're beautiful. We use them to create living fences. And what's really great for the home gardener is that you can graft. Each separate branch can be a different type of fruit. So if you plant it right, you can make some of them be early fruiting, some mid fruiting, and some late season fruiting.
Okay.
So that means you've got apples through the season, you never have too many, and it's all just as great as it can be. So anyways,
far,
we really like that.
So far we've seen apples with white flowers, but I noticed a pink
apple. Yes, we have two really special pink apples, pink flowered apples, really unusual, and there's a lot of variety in the apple world, and we like that.
So I understand that you also plant different varieties that will fruit at different times. If
Definitely.
The customer does have a lot more room,
mm-hmm.
how does that work for you?
I mean, another way to do it is just to decide on an apple orchard, and you know, that way you can have all 23 varieties, and just throughout the season you'd be harvesting different trees, and you know, and also just incorporating different types of fruits that have different fruiting seasons, and that way you've always got fresh fruit at your fingertips from your garden.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.
Thanks.